dear to your life, explodes inside. You feel your soul is burned alive,
burned alive.
When something so deep and so far and wide falls down beside, your cries can be heard so loud and clear. Your life is your own, you're in charge of yourself, master of your to me, and everything seems alright. In these days of cold affections, you sit by me, and everything's fine. This could be heaven for everyone. This world could be fair, this world could be fun. This could be heaven for everyone. This world could be free, this world could be one. In this world of cool deception.
We can stay here. This is how everything started with the music, thanks to Claude Naps, the founder of the Montreux Jazz Festival. For example, before he created the Montreux Jazz Festival in 1964, he discovered a band that he offered them the chance to play their very first show outside their country. It was here in Montreux, and the band was the Rolling Stones. At that time they were not really well known. Claude Naps went to the street of Montreux to distribute free tickets to the local, just in order to have some people during the show. But they were not really famous. For example, every edition of the Montreux Jazz Festival were organized here. So from the first edition in 1967 until 1993, all the concerts were organized here. Then they moved the Montreux Jazz Festival to the big convention center, which is the big building we have at the exit of Montreux. A very important event happened here nearly approximately 50 years ago, 4 December 1971. They invest huge amount of money to buy brand new equipment, which was the latest technology at the time. So when the studio opened its door, it was immediately considered as one of the best studio in Europe, even in the world. That's why all these artists came. Of course, the Rolling Stone as the first customer, then many other have followed understanding that something is going on in Montreux with this brand new top technology studio.
Mama, please let me back inside.
After the fire, they will decide to open a recording studio. But think about the fact that Claude Knobs organized the Montreux Jazz Festival inside the casino every year. He also used to organize many concerts all around the year, as the Frank Zappa concert in December. So all the musicians, the potential customer, they are already here. To have a recording studio inside the casino was a pretty smart business. The lake, the mountain, the view, the city is pretty charming. So why not to keep this musician here for a longer time? This is exactly what they will do. They will open the studio and they will invest a huge amount of money for the equipment. Keep looking. All the music fans, we are sleeping directly on the pontoon you have in front of you. And then a couple of years later, here we are with Queen posing right here. You can recognize the metal sticks on the left. You see where the seagull is actually standing. You can mention the other side of the casino. On the way, you will hear some information about a very, very, very famous song of Queen, recorded here in 91. It was the only collaboration they did with another artist. The control room, which was the main is located just behind the wall. If you look at the picture, you will mention that actually this control room is not designed as the standard control room we have. Usually you have the console, the desk, then a wall of glass, you know, a glass, and then the musicians are in front. This is the door of the studio, how it used to be before. When the studio closes its door, I will provide you all information in the next chapter. Actually, many people started to come here in Montreux. They started to sign on the door, you know, as a tribute for Freddie and Queen. Then the door was full of signature. They started to sign here, but until here and until here.
Under pressure. Under pressure. Pressure. Just the pieces of the man I used to be. Too many bitter tears are raining down on me. I'm far away from home, and I've been facing this alone for much too long. Oh, never told the truth to me about growing up and what a struggle it would be. In my tangled state of mind, I've been looking back to find where I went wrong.
L'anniversaire, mais on le revoit aussi très souvent en dehors de l'anniversaire, ce qui vient nous rendre visite quand même assez souvent. Ben, en fait, c'est une idée qui m'est arrivée assez naturellement. En fait, on était en contact avec les fans du monde entier hein, qui viennent chaque année ici à Montreux. Je me suis amusé un petit peu à leur poser des questions. Mais en fait, qu'est-ce que vous savez de l'histoire de Freddy à Montreux? Pourquoi est-ce qu'il est venu ici? Essayez de voir un petit peu ce que les gens savaient du passé musical. J'étais assez surpris de voir que beaucoup de gens, il y a chaque année ici, on ne savait pas du tout ce qui s'était passé. C'est comme ça que je me suis dit, bah, tiens, je pourrais faire des visibilités pour pouvoir un petit peu bah, transmettre tout ce que mon père m'a transmis, tout ce qu'il sait. Tout ce qui s'est passé ici à Montreux, c'est comme ça en fait que le groupe est venu. Ça a pris de l'ampleur au début, ben, je voyais ça comme des visites guidées un petit peu standard. Voilà, je suis le guide, vous êtes les participants, on fait la balade sur Montreux. Je me suis dit que voilà, on est dans une ville où il y a quand même des gens qui parlent de manière différente, il fallait faire ça un petit peu plus professionnellement. Donc comme tu as pu le découvrir, c'est faire avec des audio guides, tu diffuses des photos, et je pense que c'est ça vraiment qui la richesse du tour. Là, tu as fait le tour de 1 heure,
ouais.
Qui est une version un petit peu compressée du tour. Et il y a la version de 2h30 qui est en fait la version originale, où il y a beaucoup plus d'informations exclusives, beaucoup plus de photos exclusives. Tu en as déjà pu en découvrir quelques-unes durant ce tour. Pendant le tour de 2h30, il y a vraiment beaucoup plus qui est à faire aux visiteurs. Et c'est vraiment une balade qui est faite pour les Italiens, pour les francophones, pour les Russes. En fait, j'ai 5 langues différentes. Moi, je suis le guide, j'accompagne, mais vraiment tout le contenu est diffusé en mode audio pour que chacun puisse profiter à la même, de la même manière de ces informations.
Making sense of it every way I